This is the fourth Blarg. It is an art object. I've been wearing it, sleeping in it, and putting all my things in it since last fall. I'm showing how to change it from a backpack into a hammock. These are suspender clips on straps. I use them to clamp the top opening closed, but I use these straps for different things. The Blarg is wearable as a jacket or a dress or a one-piece jumpsuit or a kilt or a sarong, whatever. These straps can be used as shoulder straps or to apply pressure where necessary and to clamp things closed. This inner bag is also wearable as a jacket. Aside from these shoes, all the contents are already in it, so I can just pull everything out in one fell swoop. This single-sided zipper, I invented it for this application. It still works with the other side of the zipper. It does take some fiddling, as you can tell. It would work a lot better as a single-piece construction. It's actually very easy for a zipper maker to fabricate. I've custom ordered from a zipper repairer, something that's a single-piece construction. They just use the existing parts. But one of the goals of the Blarg is that it should be immediately reproducible anywhere in the world by the most people possible with locally available materials. So you can see that even when it's cobbled together with tape and thread, it still works. Manufacturers probably never made this because there was no demand, there was no widespread application. The Blarg is just a flat sheet folded in different ways. Conventional closures are really bad. If we have more demand, we can change the entire market. I don't believe in patents anyway, so go ahead and steal this. This is Dyneema webbing. I got it from an ultralight hammock that broke and dumped me on the ground, so I sewed the two ends of the hammock into the Blarg here. The next Blarg will not have this stuff, but for prototyping purposes this time, it saved me the time I needed to work on the main body, which is ripstop linen. That took more than a month. Ripstop linen is not available commercially. The stuff that's available are either nylon or cotton. The reinforcing threads run parallel to the warp and weft. That is totally not what I envisioned. Another goal of the Blarg is to use only raw materials that are naturally occurring, so no nylon, and materials that are currently not negatively competing with other species, so no cotton. I also envision diagonal reinforcing threads. They're much stronger. So I had to make this myself. Ideally, the reinforcing threads are just woven into the fabric. I had to sit there for one whole month while I was traveling around, sewing thousands of these threads into this base of lightweight painting linen. But I didn't have access to the existing looms with diagonal thread capabilities. It's relatively new technology, and I also didn't have space to build my own machine. Ta-da! So if you have hookups, please get in touch. Thanks for watching. Bye!